Timber Giant Bigfoot. It's been about 2.5 hours since I recorded the video that you're going to see. It was kind of an interesting situation. I don't usually come back home and, record a bit of video to go with my video. But in this instance, I'm going to, because something is happening in the forest, and it's going on right now, and it's basically just happened very recently. I was out in this area where I was today just 2 days ago, and walked all around recording and talking the whole time. That's what I do. And there was nothing out of the ordinary. And today while I was out there, there's these few trees that are, there's one large tree that's been broken off and it's wedged down between some other trees. But it kind of, it goes back and forth between some of the trees to a degree. And looks rather unusual. So I recorded that and some other stuff there. And I had this really strong feeling like, you know, there's somebody out there. And I say this a lot. And not always do I have any proof that there was anything around. But I heard this, the mumbly sound. I call it the mumbly sound. Like two men. Distinct, like there's something here and something there, and it sounded like there was some sort of interaction between the two of them. I didn't see anything. It's my dog in the other room. I didn't see anything, but I heard this, and I was already starting to have the misgiving, that, you know, that weird feeling that there was something out there, and I decided to leave, and I had a limited battery life in the camera. Since I've been home, I changed the battery. But it's starting to rain, so I walk back to my bike. When I get back to my bicycle, I have this feeling the whole time. I turn the camera back on, I don't know, 5 or 6 minutes from the bike, and I start talking. Like, I'm looking around, like I got this really uneasy feeling that something is out there. Every once in a while, I would hear something, but it was raining kind of heavily, and it was a lot of noise from the rain. And I really can't hear what's going on. And upon reaching my bike, I found this thing hanging on my bike, and I've brought it home, and I have it here. It was this thing. It was hanging on my bike, and what it is it's a piece of a cedar root or a pine tree, or I think it's cedar. It's kind of hard to tell. It smells kind of cedary to me. And to top it off, there are no cedar trees in that part of the forest. In fact, they're not anywhere until you get back into the area where a few weeks ago I thought I saw three shapes walking around or moving through the forest up a hill. And that's literally miles through the forest. The whole situation is rather peculiar, and this is what I have. It's a root, and every root that came off of it has been tied into a little bundle or a little loop of its own. You know, there's a whole bunch of them. There's one, two, three. There's three thicker, smaller ones, and three smaller, thinner ones, including the one up here, and the one big one. I don't know if this suggests something. I don't know. I can make a lot of guesses about this and draw some conclusions, but it's just guesswork on my behalf. I don't know. But anyway, I thought I'd just come home and show this once clearly. Because while I was out there, I was pretty freaked out. And I really had the feeling that whatever left us on my bike is probably there watching me. And I didn't really want to. But anyways, watch the video and you'll see exactly how this came to be. You know, as I'm standing here, just getting my stuff out, and I would have swore I seen what looked like a shape beside a tree down there. It looked like it was looking at me. Something was down there. Where is it? Somewhere back in there, one of these trees. I think it's that tall one right there, right in the middle of the screen. So I was just standing here putting bug spray on.
weird sound over there too. So that tree is like, oh, probably that one right there. There's nothing here. I haven't seen anything move off. I've never heard anything move. And you know, I rode all the way out here carrying all this stuff, cameras and all that. And I got going along here and I realized, no, there's only 22 minutes of battery time on the computer, on this camera. So I'll more than likely switch over to the SD camera. I don't know. The camera says 20, 21, 22 minutes. I don't think that's like real time because 20 minutes on this thing's countdown timer seems to be more like 15 minutes in real time. I didn't know that. I was able to charge it up last night. You'd think I'd have that part of the act together. Every time I hear things fall in the forest or crash or pop or snap or whatever, it always kind of makes my heart jump. Came from somewhere down there. I can't see it. I'm not gonna walk down there into that stuff. Just because there's some poisonous plants growing down there. I'll lift this thing up and see what's going on for a second or two. You know, it would be really amazing to get home and look at that footage from just being lifted up there just now and see that, oh, there's a creature right there looking at the camera. Wouldn't that be creepy? Get home after you walked around out here and lo and behold, there's whatever watching you. Oh, and before I forget, let's turn this around so I can see myself here. Scary, eh? Anyway, just so people know, let's stop for a minute and talk about this. I posted a video where I see this black shape off in the distance as I'm talking as usual. It's a wood knock. Anyway. Anyway, so way off in the distance, you know, like a few hundred feet away, there's this black thing that I thought for the life of me looked like a hairy person or a black, all black shape, looked kind of like a person reaching for something or standing on a tree that has actually fallen on an angle back a ways. And I was preparing a video to talk about this, all these frames, 250 frames of this stop motion stuff, and you would swear there's movement. However, I took the best frame and I blew it up really big, and you know what? Here's stuff all around. You know what? There's nothing there. So sorry for getting everybody's hopes up, but take it from me, there's nothing there. It's just a collection of shadows that gives this 3D kind of look that, along with the leaves, gives it some definition, looks like a pair of legs, but it's not. It's just a trick of shadows. So anyways, straighten that up. I don't want people to say, oh, no, you're promoting that as a Bigfoot. No, actually, I put it on the computer as what is this? Am I seeing this for real? Like, is this the creature? And upon further investigation, no, it is not. So there, I've addressed it. It's time to continue. This is just what happens. Heard some wood knocks up here as I was talking. I have my wood knocker here with me. From a deer, maybe? I don't know. I don't see any tracks here at all. Nothing. Anyway, I see some people talking about wood knockers and choice of wood knocking devices and stuff. Hang on. You know, I'm lucky we can edit all this because the camera shakes a lot. Anyway, okay. I thought I heard a wood knock out there, so I'm gonna pick this new favorite tree. Do that. You know, depending on which way you hold this thing, it makes a variety of sounds. As you can tell, two different sounds. Yeah, but you know, people are saying that choice of tool. Just, squirrel ran out there and scared me. Anyway, choice of tool and choice of tree and the repetition of this sets up a pattern of behavior on my behalf that is predictable for the creature. You know, did you hear that? Back to the tree. Another one. I can hear them way off. I'm not sure if my sound is carrying that far. I can certainly hear that sound. I can tell I hit the tree pretty hard. I'm leaving marks in the tree. There's squirrels up in the tree that I'm banging on. Don't think they like that. Anyway. I don't really hang around and wait. You know, I get criticized for that a bit. And I can understand that because a lot of other people think, you know, you're going to do some tree knocking, you should wait there, maybe half an hour. But that's just not how I do it. Bugs. I bang on the tree. Typically, I keep going. I used to bang on one tree and I'd go to another tree. However, maybe I was making a mistake by doing that. Excuse me. But at any rate, I don't hang around there very long. I make the sound and I continue. I can't help but notice there's this really nasty smell out here. It's not just here, it's at home too. I think I'm still hearing wood knocking sounds. Somewhere. Pretty far away though. Anyway, the smell is like a urine smell. It's really strong at home. And it's pretty strong out here in spots. I think it's some plant that's growing. And the rain came last night and it's had some real weird interaction with the plants or something. It's giving off this weird stinky smell. Oh yeah. Smells like a back alley in somewhere on Yonge Street in Toronto. Everybody must have a little leak. You see me walking through the forest like this, when I'm actually in the forest, in areas that I frequent, I actually take great effort and stepping in the same spots that I walk in all the time. So I don't leave a trail. Rather, I leave little dots where I walk. I'll show you. I step here, step here, no, et cetera, et cetera, all the way through here. So if somebody was really trying to find this trail, good luck. Because a lot of the time, I have a hard time remembering where the trail is. Birds out here. It's great now. I'm having a hard time seeing where I step. Something's been through here. Mosquitoes. And it was from somewhere back in here that creature I filmed, this is like 2 years ago now, was back in here. Came from just over here somewhere, just over there. And what people don't really know is that I'm way up on a, like a bluff or something like that, I guess you'd call it. This is the forest on top of the bluff. And, hear that? I don't know what that was. Anyway, we're way up in here, back here, surrounded by river. I'm still hearing banging. I mean, look at this. The wild gooseberries are growing. See, there's lots of food out here. Those things ripen, they get really quite large. They're very prickly. Okay. Well, I'm almost to the area. See, look, someone's been here. Stepped in here. Actually, it's even moved some branches that are on the ground here. Hey, what is this I see? There's a brand new tree stump back here. It always makes me a little bit nervous when I see new stuff in areas where I've been frequenting. Right now, I'm pretty close to the exact area. I think it was right here where I recorded something last year while I was making the very first shelter I made out here. Yeah, look at that right there. I don't know why I'm whispering. Look at that. Holy cow. And the tree was alive. Like, this is the spot where I always come out into this area. I walk right through here, right here. And it's like something very big has come along, broke this tree off, made sure everything went between those two trees over there. Hard to see, but there's a track right here. Right here. Big toe would be here. Heel, the ball of the foot. Heel's back in here somewhere. See that one over there? Holy shit. Yeah, he's walked around here. hasn't been very long ago. But look at the size of this. Holy crap. You know, when I see stuff like this busted off, it's really no leap of the imagination to see how this kind of stuff happens. You know, if Buddy is strong enough to break that tree off. See, another one here has been busted off recently, too. Right here. I believe. But, you know, if he's strong enough to break this stuff, holy cow. I can see where it was here. It was on that side. Maybe here, too. I'm not sure. It makes me wonder the mechanism they use to break these trees off. I'll go over and check the shelter out in a minute. You know, like, and check this out. An X right here. I guess that could be coincidental. I don't know. But it does look like it's been placed here not too long ago. Getting down some of the weeds and stuff. But anyway, you know, it's like, does the creature climb up the tree to a certain height and bend it over? Break it, or is he just using, you know, sheer muscle to break this tree? Holy. Now here's a pick handle. Here's my pick handle next to the tree. It's the size of the skinny branch. I'm hearing something. When I see this stuff, it makes me a little nervous. Like I said, see that one over there, this one right here. I'm hearing something back there. I don't know. I don't know if this is new. I don't remember. I don't recall that laying like that before, but I don't remember seeing this here. I can't tell. But look at this, eh? Oh, and check this out. Look. So it fell down, and the branches got in between these two trees, but look here. It got in between, and it's back this way again. It's been like, it's woven between these two trees. Look at this up here. Holy. And here's something else that's been pushed over right here. Somewhat recently, I don't recall that either. And look at this over here. Gee, it's been like a party back here. I see a disturbance, just a generalized disturbance here. Footprints or something. See? It's just like this shape I pass by here on almost every video. It's like an X. But the way they're crossed, and you can see it from different directions. It's starting to rain, darn it. Anyways, I wanted to go over here and check out the shelter area before it starts to really pour or something like that. You know, just for a second there, it was getting to me. Just as I started to walk over here, just like those last 10 steps, I just had an urge just to get out of here. But, more something's been walking around here, like I can just see it. There's nothing really to point to and say there's a footprint, although that kind of looks like there's one there, but you know, you can tell something's been going on back here. It's kind of giving me the chills. Damn it. There's times like this I wish I was not alone. I just heard that. Sounds like two men talking. It's right back there. Jeez. Shelter's right over there. You can see it's really grown over. Feeling like I'm not by myself out here. Came out here by myself, but it doesn't feel like I'm by myself. Especially when I see these videos I've recorded in the past, where, you know, there's something just over there moving around every time I turn my head. Maybe it's a good time to start filming where I'm not looking. Like right now, I'm walking straight ahead, looking ahead, swimming over there towards the shelter. Anyway, I think I'm gonna have to get out of here because it's starting to rain. I'm not prepared for rain, and it's a long ride home. Am I looking at something? What is that? What the heck is that? See trees. It's nothing. Kind of looks like a face. It's not though. So yep. I'm heading back to my bike. And, I don't know. It's a very uneasy feeling out here for some reason today. Especially back there. Especially when you see this stuff. How the heck has this happened? It has to be what we're thinking. You know, it's the only logical thing I can say is that it's been. This stuff has happened through the actions or activities of very large and strong creatures. For a time, living out here in the summertime. And it's in this area. Anyway. Ow. Crap. Try to hold the camera really close. I keep getting this friggin' weird, crazy feeling. See, this is the only problem. When you do predictable, repetitive behavioring, we'll call it. Or when you do these predictable patterns of behavior, that's what I'm trying to say. You become predictable. And that's really the whole point of it. But the problem is that it's very easy for something to get the upper hand on you. And to be able to predict where you're going to go next, or he knows where I'm going. I smell something really bad here. Jeez. It wouldn't be hard to get ahead of a person and say, he's gonna go back up here. Let's cut him off. I thought this is a spot I left my bike. I guess not. Oh, I see it. Good. I had to get the heck out of here today for some reason. What the heck is that? Oh, Christ. I had a really bad shiver that's happening. Are you around here? Holy crap, it's still damp. Look at this. Oh. I think something is very close by. I don't know where. It's probably watching me right now. The crown row. I'm gonna move the camera around as I'm looking at this. It's I think it's a pine root off a pine tree. Way out here. There's no pine trees here. Not for a long ways. But look at this. I'm just getting wet here. Look, almost like every single little root has been tied into a little loop. Look at that. This is something. Maybe I shouldn't have been handling it. I don't see any hair or anything on it. And it's just been broken off the ground. Look at that. It doesn't smell funny, it just smells like a piece of tree root. Interesting. I wonder if there's some meaning to it. Does it look like anything to anybody? God, I gotta get going. Man, I'm soaked. I'm gonna take this with me. I'm almost scared to turn the camera off in case something happens. Anyways, I gotta turn the camera off. It's getting wet. Timber Giant Bigfoot.